Okay, engineering students, welcome back to the second session on looking at the intermolecular forces that are there in the functional groups. In this case, is the alkyl halides. We're going to be looking at alkyl halides, aldehydes, and ketones, and you're going to see how those intermolecular forces they are going to affect the physical properties. So in the previous presentation, we saw the dominant forces in alkenes, and also aromatic compounds which do not contain something such as halogen and or groups which have got electronegativity difference between carbon of more than 0.5, then I think we saw that the up to probably 4 carbon atoms they are gases, from around 5 carbon atoms they are liquids, up to probably from around above 10 carbon atoms, probably around 15, there you get to close to 20 carbon atoms to get them as in the solid form. Now in this case, we want to look at okay, before I really come to the alkyl halides, aldehydes, and ketones, there's something which I need to mention, that the dipole moment is the separation of charge that is moderate. It's not in this case, you are going to say it's not like like a full positive or a full negative charge. You're not talking about full positive, full negative charge, like in the case of ionic compounds. For example, if I was to say something like sodium chloride, we'll be talking about full positive and full negative charges. These are ions, yeah? But in this case, we'll be talking about a partial plus, a partial positive, and a partial negative. And that occurs in compounds with an electronegativity between 0.5, and on the higher side, approaching ionic up to 1.9. If you're talking about greater than 2 or above, then we'll be talking about that bond being fully ionic. So in this case, if you're talking about a partial positive charge, moderate dipole moment, you'll be putting this, what is that word? Delta. Delta is just partial. It's not full positive charge, it's not full negative charge, but just partial. So you put the word delta. So that tells you there's a small, okay, there's a separation of charge, yeah, but not much. So in this case, you've got for the alkyl halides, you've got the group attached, which you are going to call the halogen. And for the organic compounds in this course, we'll be focusing on just four halogens. You're talking about fluorine, chlorine, bromine, and iodine. Only those four halogens. So in this case, there is an electronegativity difference between our carbon and our halogen. So that will mean that the halogen is going to pull towards itself the bulk of those. I don't know whether it's best to really do this, but if it was to have something like a carbon halogen bond, you can say the electron density is evenly distributed, like a what, like an oval like that one. But if I was to look at the electron density around the carbon halogen bond, you'll see something like this, and then there is a big. So the electron density is concentrated around the halogen, as opposed to there is a small amount of electron density on the carbon. It is keyed towards the hydrogen. So you are going to see that the electron density causes the partial class, which of course to partial class to be what? To be towards the, what do you call it? The halogen. So in this case, if I was to come to our dipole moment, you're going to be putting a sign like that, to saying that the electrons will be heading towards the halogen. Okay. Right. So in this case I had the halogen, which is which are going to show the symbol X, but in this case you are having what? The carbon oxygen double bond for the carbonyl group. Carbon is more electropositive than oxygen, so there will be the partial plus, partial minus, so that will be a polar covalent bond. Okay, so the dipole moment, it will be like that. That will be the dipole moment. So in this case we are looking at the compounds with the something which I'm going to call here polar covalent bond. And in this case, it is available in compounds such as alkylates, aldehyde, ketone, and ethers. So, if you look at the boiling points, how do you expect them? How do you expect them to vary relative or they arrange relative to probably alkenes or alkynes? The presence of those delta plus and delta minus will mean that in this case, if I've got another something which I've got a delta plus and then another one delta minus, there will be an intermolecular force between a delta minus and a delta plus of the nearby structure. So this will mean that there will be a greater force of attraction, and this greater force of attraction would mean that the boiling point and the melting point will be significantly higher than the ones for those caused by the van der Waals forces. So you're going to see that the compounds that exhibit partial covalent bond with this delta plus positive and negative, then the boiling point and the negative boiling point and the melting point are going to be significantly higher than the one obtained from by comparing compounds with a similar number of carbon atoms for compounds such as alkenes and alkynes. So the polar covalent bond in this case would result in significant melting and boiling points. So in a short while you're going to see another type of a bond, and this one is found in alcohols. It's found in a lesser extent in amines, and then in carboxylic acid. You're going to see this bond is called hydrogen bond, and that one results in a much more significant increase in the melting and the boiling point. So I really hope you've really enjoyed. So as you do that one, there are those delta plus, delta plus, delta minus, charges, delta plus, delta minus, So we'll be able to put those delta plus, delta minus. It will mean that in this case, if I've got another carbon here next to the, for example, I've got another CH3, and then I've got an X, so there will be a delta plus, so there will be intermolecular force of attraction, delta plus and delta minus. So this one, delta minus, will be, is going to be attracted to a delta plus on this other side, and that would result in increased intermolecular force, much greater than the one in the van der Waals force. So in this case, we're looking at the effect of the polar covalent bond on the physical properties like the melting point and the boiling point. So thank you very much.